Hello friends, this has been a long awaited and highly requested video after I mentioned it in my composting video a few months ago. So here goes. As a family, we love seafood and visit the docks to get fresh fish off the boats. We enjoy cleaning the prawns and the fish too, and hence we have a lot of fish waste which I love to utilize to enrich my compost. Now, the very first time I put the fish waste into my big compost pot when it was in my storeroom adjacent to the kitchen, and I covered it with some moss scraps. However, there was a smell of decomposing fish in the house for a week. The second time I put the scraps into my 24-inch tomato grow bag after the season was over, and I covered it with a really thick layer of leaves. However, due to the tiny gaps and the air pockets, again we were able to get the smell of fish in the living room for a few days, which was a complete disaster. So the third time, I decided to be more careful. Now here is an 18 by 18 inch grow bag which is lying empty, and I want to compost some prawn shells and fish waste. So at the bottom of this, I have potting mix here in which I had composted previously. Now I have put a layer of cardboard here, and now I'm going to put in the fish waste. I have some more shredded cardboard here which I'm going to put into this so that the water is absorbed. Ideally, I should have removed this colored part, but I haven't done that. And here in this bag, I have all the prawn heads which I'm going to put into this bag now. So here I've put the prawn heads and a few fish tails and everything. Now the key to this is to cover it up with completely, either with coconut coir, or I'm going to use old potting mix here, because if I cover it up with cardboard or hay or leaves, there are going to be gaps and there's going to be an unbearable smell for 7 days. So I will completely layer this with old potting mix, and on top of that, if I wish to, then I can put the dry leaves or hay or other browns. Now here is my old container of arugula. I had started greens in this, and the greens grew in this throughout the season, and I want to refresh this potting mix. So I'm just going to be using it as a brown in my compost. I do not wish to throw this away. It's very precious and I need to recycle and reuse this potting mix. So I'm going to use it now to layer my fish waste. Ginger container and lemongrass. So once I layer up the fish waste completely, there won't be any smell and there won't be any issues, because obviously I don't want fish smell in my room. So I'll just move it a bit so that the air pockets are removed, and put in more of the potting mix. And then if I want, I can put more cardboard, shredded newspaper, hay and whatever, as long as I have made a complete barrier of the prawn heads with the air. So after the old potting mix, now I have put a few layers of newspaper, and now I'm going to add the fruit and the vegetable peels of yesterday. And then cover this up completely with some more old potting mix. So here is some used potting mix that I wish to replenish, and I'm going to cover up lots of worms trying to move in. I'm just going to shift them because this thing is going to heat up quite a bit. Whatever I can find, I'll move them to the ginger container. This is a grub. Just trying to rescue these because this is going to heat up quite a bit on top. We can go to my ginger container over there. So you can see I've covered it up almost. There are a few scraps here that are poking their heads out. I'm just going to put shredded cardboard now on top of this, and this 18 by 18 inch bag is now another compost bag in my very small space balcony garden here in Mumbai. Today is 28th of April 2017. Here is the ready fish waste compost in the month of July. You can see that all the waste has broken down nicely, and this rich compost made from fish waste, prawn heads, kitchen scraps and cardboard is ready. I had also added dry leaves and hay to this grow bag, but I couldn't find the footage for that. A very important point to note is that because I layered the contents properly, and right at the bottom was a thick layer of old potting mix, there was no seepage or odor from this grow bag like I experienced the previous times. A very, very faint hint of fish smell was present for 3 days. If one stood right next to the grow bag and tried to sniff it out, and this could have been due to the small amount of seepage through the stitches of the grow bag. And in spite of this, my cats did not try to explore or dig out the contents of the grow bag. So this is how I use up fish waste to create beautiful compost inside my apartment with cats as pets and no issues. To complete this series, the next video will be on a DIY liquid fish fertilizer. Thank you so much for watching.